Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum class. This is Iqlaq here. Welcome to Software Quality Assurance course. Before jumping over to the actual course contents, I would like to tell you about the recommended textbook for this course and a bit more about the reference books. Secondly, we will also have a brief overview about the course background as well. But in the beginning, I prefer to say some motivational words which will probably assist you to develop insight about the significance of this course in need for emerging and innovative methodologies of software development. Okay, let's move to the next slide. Progression without change is impossible, and it definitely leads to the sustainability. Recently, as the businesses of almost all skills are rapidly growing in their modality and complexity. In current hyper-competitive age, office automation has become a vital part for the success and the survival of the businesses. At the same time, the software development industries have also been facing a great challenge to maintain their pace with innovative and advanced software development technologies in order to deliver more sensitive and competitive products and services. Today, the software development process is complicated as there are frequent changes in the requirements, test plans, cost effectiveness, usability, reliability, and resource allocation. Testers and developers need to align with these changes, as these changes have significant impact on software quality and delivery. Moreover, the software quality assurance process also needs to be evolved and accommodate such all kinds of changes. The ongoing transformation led to the evolution of the entire software testing industry as it shifted from quality control to the quality assurance in terms of verification and validation. It aims on continuous integration of software quality assurance components and activities in software development lifecycle, and hence continuous improvement of software development processes. Earlier on, organizations used the structured and rigid methodologies of software development like waterfall, iterative and spiral models of software development lifecycle, in which no absolute working paradigm was available during the development cycle. The testing started post-development and there was no room for making any change to the requirements. This would mean that the software would not be only bug-free, but it should be also essentially intuitive and extremely user-friendly, consistent with the user's expectations and conformance to its all the functional and the non-functional requirements, eventually delivering an ultimate solution to the businesses. However, dawn of vibrant agile methodologies is loved for its flexibility and agility, and the firms are rapidly adopting agile development practices to improve team engagement and the quality of the software. So next slide please. Let's move to the next slide. The agenda for today's lecture, the motivational word which will give you some idea about the significance of the software quality assurance in the agile technology. I already have done about that. Some of the key concepts about the quality, the basic understanding of the quality concept of the quality we will take, and we will also do something about the perspectives of the quality. Next slide, we will see look on some textbook. This is the recommended textbook which I will recommend to you, Software Quality Assurance from Theory to Implementation by Daniel Galin, and the books below can be used as reference books for this course. So earlier I was saying that the maintaining of the quality in the software products is essential for the current ages. In addition to this, the software development industry must adhere to software quality assurance policies and the strategies because of the following reasons. So I gave this title of why quality. So first of all, we'll see that the hyper competition that today's local markets has shifted to the global marketplace, and the plenty of the competitors have entered in globally. So it is very essential for the software industry to make a competitive quality products in order to win the competition among all the competitors. At the same time, the customers are becoming more knowledgeable because now the customers are having much more information about the emerging trends in marketing by the help of communication media and different internet resources. So as the customers are becoming more knowledgeable, their expectations for the quality is raising more and more. The demand for the secure and the safe software is also very essential, and it must be maintained by the software industry because it is vital for the organization to prevent and protect all the softwares from all kinds of vulnerabilities, and procuring products abiding by the professional code of ethics, keeping in view the human safety. So this is very important that the software products are developed or delivered by the software industry. They must be safe and secure in the sense of unauthorized access and some kind of the threats, etc. Next slide. The next is changing product mix. The concept of the changing product mix is the shift from the low volume high price to high volume and the low price products that have resulted in the need to reduce the internal cost of the poor quality. So maintaining a high quality with the low price and the products with the low internal cost is the key concern of the success and the survival of the businesses. This also gives you the notion of the lean production, in which we say that the companies must be capable of using minimal resources, whether those resources are physical or the virtual resources, to make more products and a greater number of the products. Then the product complexity is also increasing as the system have become more complex, and reliability requirements for the suppliers of components have become more stringent. So as the market is growing and the businesses are growing in the different domains, the complexity of the product is increasing, and it has become the demand of the businesses to make the quality product and to use the product quality products. The high level of customer satisfaction, the next is because as I said earlier that the customers of the current age are becoming more and more knowledgeable. At the same time, their level of satisfaction is also increasing. You can say that the threshold of their satisfaction is increasing, so that the companies the software industry must adhere to all the principles and the rules and the guidelines to maintain the software quality. Next slide is about understanding the quality. The notion of the quality is very difficult to define in a single statement because it is multi-dimensional concept. In the terms of the characteristics of the quality, its attributes and its parameters, and its targets, and also the quality has different views, which I will express in the next slide. So on this slide, you can see the quality is defined in brief. The quality can be considered as the conformance to the specifications and the requirements. That means if a software conforms all the specifications and the requirement which are defined in the requirement documents, then it will be said a quality product. Similarly, the customer satisfaction. Customer satisfaction is related to the external and the internal customers. External and the customer, internal customers, I hope that you know already, but I will explain a little bit about the external and the internal customers. Internal customers are those customers who are the employees or the managers of the company, and they are somehow involved in developing or producing the product for you. And all the external customers are those who pay money for your product, and they may include the end users and the stakeholders and the retailers and the distributors as well. Then the quality is sometimes considered as freedom from the defects. That means any deviation from the requirements is regarded as a defect. And a good quality product contains zero defect. So a defect-free or fault-free product will be called a quality product. The quality product actually fills the gap between the user's expectations and the perceptions. So that means if your product which you are producing or delivering to those users, if it meets all the expectations of the users and it is perceived by the users as they were expecting for. Similarly, the quality is fitness of the use, and moreover, if it fulfills the specified or implied needs, then the product will be called a quality product. Quality is the fitness of the purpose. This is also defined by the Juran, a quality guru. And finally, we can say that the product is a quality product. You can say the degree of excellence with which it meets. So this is defined in Oxford English Dictionary. Next slide is about the views of the quality. You can see here there are different personals who are involved in development and the usage of the product owners, the development team, the project manager, end users, project sponsors, they all are having different views of the software quality. So these are the key stakeholders in Agile. In this slide, we will see different views of the quality. The transcendental view says that the quality cannot be viewed by some document. It is just a matter of the experience. So the attributes are which can be defined by the quality. They are from, you can say, they come from the experience. The value-based concept or the view of the quality explains that we see the quality product if it is valued by the marketplace. That in other words, you can say that what is the worth of the of your product in the marketplace. So on the basis of that, we say that some product is a quality product. Next is the user view of the product. Both the internal and the external users, I already have explained about the users and types of the users and the user's view. The manufacturer views is about the product quality and the process quality, that are the transformation processes which are included in transformation, the raw material into the finished goods, whatever you are producing. And as the organizations are originated on products or the services, That means they are producing some kind, some sort of the product or some sort of the service. The service quality is also a manufacturer view. Similarly, the organizational view or the quality culture, where quality is seen as everyone's responsibility within the organization. So manufacturer views the quality in these different dimensions. So here I look at this slide. This is about a process. This in the previous slide I talked about the process quality. So just simply we are trying to understand what is the process. By definition, a program in execution is called a process, but in the matter of the quality, we say that process is a procedure of the transformation in which the inputs are taken from one side and outputs are given on the other side in the way of your product or some service. And the quality process gives always an effective process and an efficient process. Next is about process-based quality activities. So this slide is just telling you how you can improve the quality by improving the processes of transformation. So in this diagram, you can see that first of all, we define the process, and then on the basis of those processes, we transform the resources into the finished goods. That means we develop the product and then we assess the products based upon different specifications and the requirements. And if it meets the requirements, which are well defined already, are predefined requirements, then we standardize the process. And otherwise, if it says no, then we improve the process by using different kind of the models and the strategies or the guidelines of the software quality assurance, and then we again move back to the development of the product. Next is about the basic building blocks of the quality. You can see at the top of this diagram, this is managing of the quality. It has two dimensions to work. One is producers perspective, and second is at the right side, it is consumer perspective. So obviously, producer's perspective is about the conformance to the specifications and the requirement, and the cost as well, and the efficiency of the product, and there are lots of other attributes which come under the umbrella of the consumer perspective. Definitely, it's also having interaction with the production team and the procurements of the resources. At the other side, the consumers are also interested in cost effective products and the quality characteristics, in the sense they are best fit of their needs. At the same time, consumers are also interested in the different marketing strategies which are used by the distributors or some warehouses or some retailers. So we can see that we can work in two different dimensions to maintain the quality of software product. Next slide is about the internal and the external quality. This is just understanding about the explicit and the implicit quality. Commonly we say the explicit quality to the external quality as well. This is the quality as perceived by the stakeholders and the end users. So this, you can say that this can be derived from the relationship between the environment and the system. For example, the reliability of the product or the robustness, that means how much it is supporting to the user, its recoverability or its fault tolerance and its usability. The implicit quality of a product is the quality of the software, particularly of the source code, that eventually delivers the external quality. So you can say that if we maintain the internal quality, it leads to the external quality of the product. It is a metaphor manufacturing lines derived immediately from the product or process description, for example, the efficiency and the testability of the of some product or some software module, that will be considered as an implicit quality of the software. This is about my lecture first, and putting all together, I hope that you will have a good understanding about the stuff we discussed today. Inshallah, in our second lecture, we will uncover some of the additional concepts regarding quality evolution and try to understand some key terminologies used in software quality assurance. We will also try to make our understanding about the quality management system. And finally, we will look upon some of the essential quality standards. Till that, take care. Allah Hafiz.